If you've watched TED Talks regularly, then perhaps you may have come across a very popular talk by the British neuroscientist Anil Seth. Very popular talk. And he has done many similar talks elsewhere, where he argues that what we call reality is a controlled hallucination, where he suggests that our brains actively construct our perceptions of the world by combining sensory input with internal predictions. This means that what we experience as reality is not a direct reflection of the external world, but rather the brain's best guess, shaped by its predictive models and constrained by sensory data. He even extends this idea to the self. I presume he means the personal self, where he says that our sense of being a conscious individual is also a kind of hallucination generated by the brain. So I have several objections to Anil State's hypothesis, and I am suggesting that consciousness itself might be hallucinating the brain. My argument or critique shifts the focus to a deeper view. If we consider consciousness as primary and material reality, which of course has to include the brain and body, as secondary, then one can easily argue that the brain itself is a construct within consciousness. And this aligns maybe with certain aspects of analytic idealism. And I do believe that our so-called brain as an object is the appearance of the conditioned mind. So I am proposing that all physical phenomena are manifestations within consciousness rather than independent entities. So, in this view, just as Seth argues that the brain hallucinates reality, I am suggesting that consciousness hallucinates the brain as part of its broader experience of material reality. While Seth's model is grounded in neuroscience and emphasizes how biological processes create our subjective experiences, but they don't. We know that biological processes are neural correlates of experience. Biology itself is a subjective experience. So my critique invites you to question whether these processes that Anil talks about themselves exist within a deeper, more fundamental domain of consciousness, which is not personal but non-local, formless, borderless, infinite, spaceless, timeless, incomprehensible, and eternal. So this perspective, of course, challenges the materialist assumption, and I hope will open debates around the idea that consciousness emerges from matter into a deeper understanding where matter is a construct that arises within consciousness, and actually, so is the brain. So, and expanding on that idea, we could say that all matter, including the brain, is not an independent objective reality, but rather an interpretation generated by human perceptual activity and the conditioned mind. This perspective suggests that what we call matter is a conceptual framework imposed by our cognitive and sensory activities, which are modifications of consciousness to make sense of the underlying activity of consciousness. So in this view, perceptual experiences, sound, sight, touch, are fluctuations, vrittis, and they do not exist, pre-exist in the material world, but are modified expressions of consciousness itself. So let me know if you relate to this and what your view is and why this view that I'm suggesting goes deeper than the brain hallucinating, the personal self, and the material world. How can a material object like the brain hallucinate another material object like the world? Doesn't make sense to me. Mind, conditioned mind, which is also the individual self, is a modification of consciousness, and the physical brain and the body and the world are its symbolic expressions. I'd love to know your thoughts. My latest book is Digital Dharma, How AI Can Elevate Spiritual Intelligence and Personal Well-being. And if you want to continue conversing with me, do go to deepakchopra.ai.